In the previous episode, I gave you a very short, basic introduction to type system in Dart, and then we used types to make the serialization process more safe. We added some type annotations, so our code is more explicit. So before we were decoding a string, and the standard JSON library was able to decode a string into a list of maps. And then we slightly improved that by introducing a message type so that the list was no longer general with maps that can have any keys and any value. And we restricted that. We added additional constraints that the list is only about messages and the list can only hold instances of a message class. So in order to do that, we needed to help Dart a little bit. So we added this constructor, which shows how to translate a map which has certain keys, such as subject and key, and how to translate them into the fields we defined in the message class. But as you can see, if we had more fields here, it would be pretty much repetitive. So this kind of code is usually called boilerplate, because this is something for us humans obvious that you need to assign this key from JSON with the same name to the field in your message class. So it would be nice if there is a way to do it automatically. Luckily enough, in Dart, it's possible. So first thing we need to do, we need to add a library to our project. So it's the first time we are adding an external library. So it's pretty exciting. So I need to go to a file called pubspec, as we did before with assets. Before we were using this section Flutter, and now we will be operating in dependencies and dev dependencies. So we need to add two dev dependencies to automate the serialization process. So the first dependency is called build runner, and the second one is called JSON serializable. If I click save, the VS Code is automatically fetching those libraries for me, as you can see. So the window, the pop-up opens, and it's running Flutter packages get command, which fetches those libraries from the internet. And there is no error, so we are good. Now we need to go back to the message class, and we need to add a decorator called JSON serializable, uppercase. So VS Code is not smart enough to help us in this case, so we need to add our package by hand, and the package is called the JSON annotation. And now the errors disappear. Lastly, we need to add a section called part, and we need to name it after the class. So in our case, it's message. We need to add a suffix g. So right now it says that this file doesn't exist. And this is the file that will hold the functions that will be used to translate our list of maps into a list of instances of the message class. So we need to generate that file. So I need to go to the terminal and I need to execute flutter packages pub run build runner build. That's a pretty long command. And this now uses the library we included and generates, it looks at our class, at our message class, and generates this file message g, which will have the functions that will describe how to translate a map into a message instance. Okay, so it's done. As you can see, the message disappeared. And now we just need to replace this constructor where we manually specify each field in the message class and the correspondence to the map we are getting here from the JSON and which key corresponds to which field. So we no longer need to do it by hand. We can just say that this is message from JSON. So the output of this function must be returned from this constructor. So we just need to prefix it with a word factory. So factory is just a way to say that this constructor returns a value from this function. No errors. And let's refresh our application. And it works. So just to test it, let's add another entry here. Let's save. Let's refresh the app and we can see the entry. So the serialization works as expected. And now we no longer need to manually say which entry in a map, which key value pair corresponds to which field in our class. We can just add new class, rerun this long command, and the serialization code doesn't need any further changes. So this is the external library that does this for us. We no longer need to be bothered. We just need to specify our fields in our class, and the process of encoding and decoding is being done automatically. So it's pretty nice, especially if your application grows. So that's pretty much it, and see you in the next episode.